This is a case where we are going to deal with the genuineness of financial statements. Look at this. Vitex Private Limited has reported good profits and have all the financial and performance indicators at either acceptable level or better than that. However, working capital facilities are frequently overdue and it seems like they have high liquidity strain. They have now come up for renewal of working capital facilities. What you should do now? See, when their financial indicators, performance indicators are at acceptable level or even better than that, then ideally they should not be having liquidity issues. Or the liquidity issue can arise when there is a steep increase in demand and they could not meet that requirement because their existing credit facilities are not adequate enough. So that can be one reason. But here, they have just come for renewal of working capital facilities and there is no indication that the sales are all on increasing trend. So what is the issue? Why, despite having a better financial ratios or better than expected financial ratios, they are facing liquidity strain? So here, due diligence is required. It got to be strengthened. So what you have to do as a banker is you have to check the genuineness of their financial statements. Yes, of course it is audited financial statement, but you can double check. What you can do, if it is a company, you can cross verify the financial statements that were submitted to your bank with that of financial statements submitted with registrar of companies. Okay, so companies are mandated under companies law to file their annual return including their financials. Okay, so you can make a search in registrar of companies. You can engage the services of professionals, or as a banker you yourself can do, because this is available in public domain. Just by making a payment of 50 rupees, you will be able to download the financial statement submitted by the company with ROC, registrar of companies. Take that and compare it with what they have filed with the bank. If both are one and the same, okay, so on that part you can be sure of. But there had been instances in the past where some customers, with an intention to cheat the banker, they fabricated their financials. They presented ratios, the financial indicators at better level or more than what was expected. So the project or their loan proposal becomes financially sanctionable. Okay, so those were the business units which had eventually become a failure at later part. So whenever you come across a situation where the financials are too good, but on the operation side their credit facilities are continuously irregular or overdue, then do this cross verification of financial statements with what they have filed with ROC. You should also go through their income tax returns. Look at the way they have computed the profits that is reported to income tax. Of course, the book profit and the profit as per income tax will vary because of adjustments provided as per income tax law. But the starting point, the book profit, what they have captured in their computation of income, that should match with profits what they have reported in their financial statements. Okay, so do that cross verification as well. And now recently what we have is verifying the credentials of the auditor itself. Okay, so the chartered accountant who signs this financial statement is mandated to generate something known as UDIN. Okay, so this UDIN, they are supposed to mention in their certificate, say in the audit report. And as a banker, you can visit the website of Chartered Accountants, Institute of Chartered Accountants. That is www.ica.org. And there you can go and verify the UDIN. Okay, so in that way, you can ensure that whatever the financial statements that were submitted by the customer, which has audit report and it will have a mention of UDIN. So you can relate that UDIN number with what is available in the above website. So in that way also you can verify the genuineness of financial statements.
Are you struggling in understanding banking creditor related matters like financial ratio analysis, cash flow and fund flow analysis, fund-based and non-fund-based products, term loan appraisal? Then this course is for you, banking credit analysis process. Enroll now, more details in description below.